guys, Trilby Hat here. This is my first official formatted episode, so let's get it started. Alright, so here's the deal. I'm sorry about this being late. I actually had wanted to get this out on Friday, but you see, the thing is, I've been super busy. Summer break just started, and all my friends seem to want to do a bunch of different things, so every day seems to be busy. In fact, I am filming this on Father's Day, and I had been out with my father today, so I was even busy today. I got super lucky getting that I got any time to do this at all. So, yeah. Also, I'm not feeling 100%, so if I seem a little bit not perky at all, it's because I'm just kind of tired. So, first matter of business is the movie section. The movie that I am going to review right now is a movie called Up. You may have seen it, you may have not. So here's the deal. Up is a movie about this elder gentleman who had lost his wife a few years back and had always promised her that he was going to one day go on this big adventure. So he attaches all these balloons to his house and he flies away and he wants to go on this big adventure for him and his wife. He accidentally brings along this little scout named Russell, and him and Russell go on this big adventure where they find this fancy giant bird and this talking dog named Doug. If you haven't seen the movie, I actually do really recommend it. It is one of Pixar's stuff, and you know, Pixar does a lot of really good films. It's very cute, kind of bittersweet, a lot of sad points in it. There's some cute laughs. Not something you want to go out for if you want to just have a laughing riot, though. It's not hilarious, it's kind of sad, but it's very well written.
However, if any of you want to go see the 3D experience, I don't recommend that. You kind of sit there and you notice the 3D for like the first 10 minutes of the movie, and then it stops being a big deal after that, and it kind of just gets old. You end up wasting money by buying the 3D experience. Don't recommend it. But as for the movie itself, I would definitely say go out and watch it. It was a lot of fun. Cute. Want to bring your kids to it. Want to bring family to it. It's probably one of the few out right now that I would wholeheartedly recommend.
Alright, so literature. I had just finished the first book of The Looking Glass Wars. And for those of you who don't know what that is, it's this book kind of based off of Alice in Wonderland.
Now, when I say kind of based off Alice in Wonderland, I mean it's very, very loosely based off it. It's like there's characters named after characters, itty-bitty little things that kind of go with the story, but overall, not really, you know, it's not like you're reading like a sequel to Alice in Wonderland or anything like that. The story is about this princess named Alice, who lives in Wonderland with her mother, Guinevere, and her mother is a queen, that's why she is a princess. They have this aunt named Aunt Red, and she's evil, and she wants the throne for herself, but she doesn't have it. There's a bodyguard who's the Mad Hatter. He's pretty cool. He does martial arts, he does stuff. It's pretty awesome. He has lots of swords and knives, and his hat turns into like this wielding kind of circular weapon. It's kind of weird. It's like he flattens it, like squish, and then swords come out of the brim. I don't know how that feels to wear. That doesn't sound very comfortable to me, but that's pretty much what he does. A couple other characters you'll notice. Fun book. Not exactly a hard read, but very enjoyable. If you like books based off other classic stories, and you'll probably enjoy this. I don't know if I recommend it to buy it, but if you want to go out to the library and like rent it or something, or if you have a friend who owns it, yeah, give it a read. It's actually pretty entertaining. Alright, so television shows. Since it's summer, there's not exactly a lot of television on right now. And, get this, my cable's out. So, I'm not great right now with television shows. So I guess I'm just gonna talk about So You Think You Can Dance now. Alright. Evan. He did really good this week. You know, for a guy who's really smooth, you know, kind of does a lot of stuff that's kind of more slick. The jive was actually really, really good. Him and Randy did a brilliant job of that. The other dancers, can't really see anyone bad this year, you know? But there's normally like that one person who keeps going through and I don't understand why. And I'm not really seeing anyone. They're all very, very good. And I really don't want any of them to go. It's not like, hey, that person needs to go. It's more like, oh, who are they gonna bump off? It's, you're not asking for anyone really to leave at this point. So yeah, Evan, brilliant job on his jive. I was pretty excited when I was watching that. And his brother, Ryan, getting into season 6 to Vegas. Oh, good job, boyo. Man, that's exciting. I am so excited for him right now. Mm-hmm. I really hope he gets into the top 20 because he deserves it. Him and his brother are completely amazing dancers. I stick by my comment about it not being fair. Having the two of them at the same time out there when they were picking the top 20. And they're going, you're going to get in and you're not. That was just brutal. They shouldn't have done that. That was mean. But good to know. Maybe we'll get the two brothers. Maybe they'll both be winners. That'd be pretty awesome. In fact, I'll be voting for you, Ryan. Just letting you know. Just like I'm voting for Evan now. Casper Zax, 2 years in a row. Let's see that happen. Wild card. Green Day CD. The newest one that came out. I got it. I got it off iTunes. Full thing. Pretty cool. A little bit gimmicky. If you don't like CDs with gimmicks that are going on telling an entire story throughout the CD, you're probably not gonna like this CD. It's following these two characters, Christian and Gloria, and just like their life in George W. Bush's America. Pretty intense stuff going on, lots of stuff about religion, lots of stuff about war. Good if you like your activist music. It sounds pretty good. I'm a little disappointed that their main song on it is Know Your Enemy, because it's super repetitive. And, it's a nice sound, but the repetition gets old really quickly. There is one song that I'm absolutely in love with on the CD, and that's the 21 Guns. Beautiful, beautiful piece. It's kind of more of a ballad. It's not so much a rock song compared to the other ones. If you want more of the rock, poppy rock song, I'd go with Peacemaker. That's some fun stuff right there. Besides that, buy this CD. Do it. It's great. If you're not into gimmicks, probably not going to be your cup of tea. But you like your rock music and you like your activist stuff, you'll probably enjoy this CD. So I recommend buying it. Alright, so that's really all I got going on right now. I'm just going to keep saying, Evan, do well. It's amazing that you have come as far as you have. I am so happy for you and your brother right now. Casper and Zach, activists, keep voting. Man, keep those guys up there. Let's see Evan win this thing, eh? One of these days, I promise, I'm going to get a Trilby hat, and I will actually live up to my name. For right now, I'm just going to be wearing random hats that I have in my closet, and I have a lot of random hats in my closet, so you will still see me in a hat until I actually end up buying a Trilby hat. Alright, so have fun!